At the beginning of this year, I had the opportunity and the blessing to participate in a conference in Rome. And the conference was about the prayer of liberation and exorcism. And I learned so many things, and I would like to share some of it with you. I would like to share also today a story that I learned from the conference that I participated. There was a priest in Rome. Her name is Father Gerard. He was used to receive phone calls from his parishioners to go to bless their homes. But this time, the phone call from his parishioner was different, because this one was asking him to go to bless his home because it was infested. He reported to the priest that something weird was happening in his house, that sometimes the light will go on without anyone turning the lights on, or the lights will go off without anyone turning the lights off, or the doors will open and close, or sometimes he will hear people talking in the middle of the night when there was nobody there. Sometimes there was a lot of noise, for example, in the kitchen when they were in the living room. And when they would go to the kitchen to check what was happening, the noises started to happen in the living room and no one was there. So he was afraid because of what was happening in that house. And also he was renting the house, and the people who will move in will last only for a month, because they will be terrified of living in that house. So that's why the priest was contacted to go and to bless the house because of what was going on. It was the first time for Father Gerard to receive a phone call like that. He was used to bless the homes, but never in a case like this. So Father Gerard called the Father Amorth, who is the official exorcist of the Diocese of Rome, and he asked him for some advice. So Father Amorth suggested that he should call a sensitive that he knew in the northern part of the country. And he provided to Father Gerard his phone number. So Father Gerard went to the house that he was to bless, and he called the sensitive. A sensitive is someone who is able to use his senses even though he is not in the place physically. It's someone who is able to see even though he's not there. Someone who is able to smell when he's not physically there, or someone who is able to touch something when he is not physically there. So this person received a special gift from the Holy Spirit. They are called the sensitive. They help in a special way the exorcists. So Father Gerard met the owner of the house outside the house, and the owner gave him the key to go inside to bless it. So he was going to walk in alone. And he was a little afraid because he had not much experience with it. So he called the sensitive for some support and for him to be praying for him. So Father Gerard went into the house. As he was walking in, he realized that there was a living room as he was opening the house. But the lights were off, and it was dark. So he wanted to turn the lights on, and he found the switch to do that, but he would be moving the switch to the on position, and the lights would still be off. So he wanted to open the windows to get some light from the outside, and the windows were locked. So he mentioned that to the sensitive and said, I don't know what's going on, but I can't turn the light on, and I can't open the windows either. And the sensitive said, don't worry about it. It is him. He doesn't want you to have some light in the house. But I will guide you. Continue praying, and I will guide you. The sensitive said to the priest, walk all the way down the hall, and you will see a staircase on your right side. And it's interesting, again, because the sensitive was, hadn't been there in that house. So, but he was able to see the house, thanks to the grace and the gift that he received from the Holy Spirit. So he was guiding the priest. He went, and effectively he found the staircase on the right side. He started to go to the second level where the sensitive indicated him to go. As he was walking down, as he was walking up the stairs, he noticed that the door of the second floor was opening and closing. And he was a little terrified by seeing that. So he continued, and the priest asked the sensitive, what should I do? This is what I see. The door is closing and opening, and no one seems to be there. The sensitive said, don't worry, it is him. Just continue praying and go inside that room. So finally he goes into the room, and it was dark. Once he was in the room, he sensed the presence of someone who was there. He was able to see like someone was looking at him, but he didn't know from where or whom, but he felt the presence of someone looking at him. The sensitive said to him, go into the wall, and then down toward the ground you will see an outlet. Take that outlet out and put your hand inside, and you will find a little box. So the priest went, and he did as he was asked to do, and he found a little box. When he had the box in his hands, he said to the sensitive, okay, I found it. What should I do? And he said, now get out of the house as soon as you can. And so the priest started to walk all the way down to the first level. And by this time, he experienced that presence that he felt before was even closer to him, and there was too much hatred coming from him, whoever that person was, or whoever that what present was. So he went all the way down. It was a little difficult because there was no light. It was all in darkness. And he managed to go to find the door, the main door, and to go out of the house. Once he was out of the house, he walked all the way down to the street, and then he called the sensitive and said and asked him, okay, I have it now, and I'm out of the house. What should I do? And the sensitive said, now open the box and throw everything that you see inside on the ground. So he did it, and he noticed that there were some bones in the little box. So he did that, and then told the sensitive, okay, it is done. What should I do? And then the sensitive said, that's it. It is done. You did a good job. So he said, yeah, but what about him? And the sensitive asked him, whom? Him, he said, the priest. Him, the one that you mentioned that when I was there, I couldn't turn the light on, and you said that it was him blocking it. The windows, I couldn't open them, and you said that it was him. The presence around me, you said that it was him. He said, yeah, but he is gone. Turn around, the sensitive asked him, turn around. And when he turned around, he saw that the house, the windows were open, and there was light inside. So the priest asked the sensitive, so what happened? He said, well, the house was infested. And now through your prayers and by you being able to find the thing that the devil was using to infest the house, then the house has been liberated and has been blessed by your prayers. What happened in the house? The priest asked him. And he said, what happened was that the owner of the house was someone who was involved with satanic cult, and he made a pact with the devil. And to seal that pact, he went and he got some bones from the cemetery and dedicated the whole house to the devil. So in that way, he opened and welcomed his house to the devil. So the house was infested. There was a diabolic presence in the house. And that's why they were seeing what you were describing at the beginning that was happening to the house. So I mentioned that example of this priest who shared the story with us because last weekend we were talking about how the devil wants to take us away from the Lord. And he uses so many ways and so many tricks to confuse us and to take us away from Christ. Last Sunday, we talked about the most common one, the most common thing that the devil uses, which is temptations. Remember how we talk about temptation is an unhealthy curiosity. And temptations are given by everyone. And they're coming not from God, but from the devil. That's a way for him to take us away from Christ. But then today, we talk about the infestation. And the infestation is a little stronger presence of the devil that he wants us to be away and not to have a loving relationship with Christ. Infestation is what could happen to a house that has been dedicated to the devil, or who has been, or the owner or the person living there has been involved with a satanic cult. Or sometimes if there was a homicide happen in that house or a grave crime, the devil uses that to enter and to infest that house. So the infestation could happen to a house or to an object. And sometimes people even put in their homes objects that are related to the devil or things that belong to the new age, like a pyramid or something like that that is connected to the devil or that was dedicated or participated in a black mass and then is taken into home. The devil uses that for an infestation. We're talking about this is because our Lord Jesus Christ is our Savior and our Redeemer. We are not to be afraid of the devil. We are to come closer to Christ. The devil is not as powerful as he presents himself. He is not everywhere. God is everywhere, and God has all the power. The devil is not everywhere. That's why he has to give us temptations and infestations. But Christ is everywhere. He's more powerful. And in Christ, and only in Christ, we find salvation and everlasting life. And when the Lord gives, he gives in abundance, as we see in today's gospel. From the two loaves of bread and the two fish, he was able, from the seven loaves of bread and the two fish, to provide food to 4,000 people. So he gives, and when he gives in abundance. Especially when he gives his graces, he gives in abundance. We can ask Christ to give us the grace of faith, to be able to believe and more. And I invite you to love Jesus Christ with all your heart, with all your mind, with all your soul. It is in him and only in him that we find our salvation and redemption. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, amen.